Hello everyone, myself G. Venkata Gangadhar Rao. Currently I am working as a physics lecturer in Government Degree College at Mandapetam. So due to Corona, all students are watching online classes, but most students are unable to watch online classes due to lack of internet facility at the time of being. To prevent this, I am uploading physics lessons on my YouTube channel, namely Telugu Gamanam channel. These videos are not only lessons, but also elaborates animation in physics. I promise you that these lessons are never get bored. Apart from this, all these lessons are uploaded in two versions, namely in Telugu, in English. In each lecture lesson video contains description. In the description, you can download the link of lecture notes and so that you can prepare for the exam. Now I am explaining the lesson, namely called wave optics. This is wave optics lesson is in physics chapter of thought paper. It is most common syllabus for 10 universities of Andhra Pradesh and also in 6 universities of Telangana. To begin with, I shall go to the first unit of wave optics. In first unit, namely called as aberrations. Generally, aberrations are called defects of images due to lenses. In first unit, that contains 8 topics. First, introduction. In that introduction, the topic was deviation produced by a lens. Second, chromatic aberration. Third, achromatism for two lenses in contact and separated by distance. Next, monochromatic aberrations. In monochromatic aberration, fourth topic was spherical aberration. In that aberration, we will discuss about the methods for minimizing the spherical aberration. Fifth, coma, methods for minimizing the coma. Sixth, astigmatism, methods for minimizing the astigmatism. Seventh, curvature of field, methods for minimizing the curvature of field. 8th, that is last topic, distortion, methods for minimizing the distortion. First we will discuss about the introduction to the aberration unit. Consider any lens in the field. When light rays coming from the object are incident on lens, then after it refract into the lens and forms an image for the object at the point I. So, when the deviations produced by actual size or shape and position of an image of an object are called aberrations. This is our definition for the aberrations. That means, when the image formed for the image with respect to object contains any deviation in size, shape or position called aberrations. Here deviation generally we called as a change. Generally aberrations are two kinds. That means they are formed either due to light or due to optical system. Here the aberrations formed due to light is called chromatic aberration. That is, when white light is used, then the formed image due to lens is called chromatic aberration. When the aberrations are formed due to optical system, then that aberrations are called monochromatic aberrations. That means the monochromatic aberrations which are occurs due to the single wavelength emitting light rays incidenting on lens, they are spherical aberration, coma, astigmatism, curvature of field and distortion. Now we will discuss about the first topic in our lesson, that is the deviation produced by a thin lens. Here thin lens means what? Its thickness is very small. If you take the thick lens, its thickness is very large. So we need to consider the object distance, image distance with respect to the thick lens also. But here thin lens is very small, so that object distance and image distance we can take from the optic axis. Now consider a convex lens L. As we know that the convex lens look like an idli shape, but the cross section of the convex lens will be look like this shape as shown in this animation. The line passing through the center of the lens is called principal axis. The line passing through the center of the lens and perpendicular to the principal axis is called optical axis. These two are coincident at the center, namely called as C. Now consider the focal length of this lens is F. Now consider an object O on the principal axis. The light ray coming from the object is incident on lens at a point A. In case lens is not there, then the light ray travels straight as along the direction of OA. But due to lens, the light ray refract in the lens and forms an image at a point I on the principal axis. Consider the angle between the line OA and refracted light ray is delta. This is called deviation angle. Let us consider the angle between incident ray and the principal axis is alpha, and the angle between refracted ray and the principal axis is beta. Here the incident ray is incident on a lens at a height h from the principal axis. Now consider the object distance is minus u and image distance is v from the optic axis. Here minus u means the distance measuring the object distance in left hand side of lens. Hence we will always get negative sign, but the image distance get positive sign, that is plus v. From the figure, the deviation angle can be written as delta is equal to alpha plus beta. Here in a triangle, the exterior angle is equal to the sum of the two interior angles. Hence the deviation we can write as delta is equal to alpha plus beta. Assume that this is first equation. Here alpha and beta are very small angles. We can write as a alpha approximately equal to tan alpha and beta approximately equal to tan beta. Hence from the shown animation, triangle AOC and triangle AIC, we can write as alpha approximately equal to h by minus u, beta approximately equal to h by v. Assume that this is second equation. Hence from 1 and 2 we know that delta is equal to alpha plus beta. Put alpha beta values in 1. Therefore delta is equal to h by minus u plus h by v. By taking h common in the above equation implies delta is equal to h into 1 by v minus 1 by u. Hence the deviation produced by lens is delta is equal to h by f. Because from the lens maker's formula, 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. Here u and v are the object distance and image distance from the optical axis of the lens. Hence the deviation produced by lens is always delta is equal to h by f. It is came under the lens maker's formula. Here the deviation directly proportional to height of the light ray which is incident on lens. As the height increasing, the deviation also increasing, and also as the height decreasing, the deviation also decreasing. Similarly, the deviation inversely proportional to focal length of the lens. As the focal length of the lens increases, the deviation of a specified light ray decreases, and vice versa. This will be useful for in aberrations topic. So this is our topic. So please subscribe our Telugu Gamanam channel for more lecture videos. Click the bell icon for notifications. If you want to get lecture notes for this lecture video, click the description link below in the lecture video. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the next lecture video. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.